What is up? Welcome back to another video. So a few days ago, I tried out a CMS called Casey CMS. Expect a video on that soon. And they actually only have a GraphQL endpoint API to talk to the CMS and build your front end. And I had not used GraphQL probably in, 3-4 years. It's never been needed, and it's always like an optional thing. And there's lots of people that say we're over GraphQL, it's no longer viable. But actually, in using Casey, I realized how handy GraphQL is, especially when you set it up correctly in your front end. And that's what I want to show you in this video. This, I think, is the best way to set up GraphQL in Nuxt 3. All right, so I will not be going into what GraphQL is in this video. I'm assuming you either have an opinion or you actually used it before. And so what you want to do with GraphQL is query exactly the data that you want. And that query language is pretty neat. And it feels like, hey, there's a schema here. Maybe I can do something with TypeScript. It's pretty interesting to see how all these things play together. And so I wanted to have the leanest, cleanest, simplest, most elegant interface to GraphQL from Nuxt 3. And I don't personally really like the Apollo server with all its overhead and all these lovely features that I probably won't use. So I found this amazing tool. Let's go to my browser here. So there's the Nuxt GraphQL client. And let's go to GitHub so we can give proper props to the person who built it. And this is by Desai. Whatever, you know what I mean. This thing is so cool. So it actually has zero configuration, what we love about Nuxt modules. It has full TypeScript support, multiple client support. So you can actually go to Daisy CMS, HiGraph CMS, SpaceX, and then connect all those things separately. So be super clean. And then we have hot module reloading for GraphQL documents. I had to learn what those are. I'll show you in a sec. And then it's a super minimal client, and it does code generation, which to me is the magic that I hadn't seen before at all. And so let's just have a look at how I set up my Nuxt environment to make this GraphQL thing feel kind of like out of the box, magical, and super simple to use. All right. So here is on the left side my VS Code with my Nuxt setup, as you can see. My config is very empty. I just have Nuxt GraphQL client. And on the right, you actually see whatever came out on the front end. And so what this client does, it actually connects to your schema. And then based on the queries that you have set up, figures out all the types and all the schemas and data that it needs to be able to query that in an easy way. And then it makes you actually composables that you can use to just query that data, which to me was like mind-blowing because it's only fully typed. It's so cool. So essentially what this thing allows you to do, you have an environment variable here where you just set up your endpoint, your GQL host, put whatever you want there. I have a HiGraph one. It can be Casey, it can be SpaceX, you know, all that stuff. And so what it then does, it looks for a queries folder where you put your queries. Well, I have a products query that is literally just getting my product's name and slug from this endpoint that I put in my environment variables file. And based on this, it will now on yarn build or NPM build or run dev, whatever you do to get your stuff running, it actually does a bunch of code generation. So when we have a look in the Nuxt folder, there's now a GraphQL folder with a whole bunch of stuff all about what it was able to find out about my endpoint. Right, and then there's a whole bunch of types, and it actually now made a function called GQL products. And if you look back, if you had some eagle eyes before, there's a products query here. So when I now go to my app.view to query these products, I just have to do this. I have a top level await in my setup function, and I do GQL products. Done. And it even adds things like mutation. So if you have variables of like a where a slug is this or stuff like that, you can just add it here and do what you need to do. And so then I just get my data and I run it here, which means all my data queries happen in these GraphQL files here, which is so clean because it's all in one place. And look at this magic. Let's say I want a description, right? OK, make it safe. And there it is. So there's a hot module reload for these queries, and it just does the query for me. And this is just magical. And there's a few other composables that they offer you, which I'm not really showing you here, but we can kind of go over them. Like, it's really interesting where you have these GraphQL functions, like the get users for the user's query and comments and like mutation stuff. But then also there's a bunch of different composables. So you can actually, with your GraphQL instance, do a bunch of stuff, or you can do an async data call and then actually set some cache and do some other things. So there's a bunch of little extra things. Like, imagine you have to have a token to be able to query something. It offers all this. And it's just magical, because my Nuxt code is so clean. The only thing I have is the component or a module. Then I have a GraphQL file where I query things, and that's it. And of course, when this grows, it gets more complex. You can do fragments and all that other stuff, and you might need a token to be able to connect to something, but it offers all this out of the box, and it's super lightweight. Anyways, this is what I wanted to show you, and I might actually start to be a bit more excited about GraphQL, because this setup is so nice. It's such a clean Nuxt 3 setup that I just enjoy working with it. Anyways, cheers. Happy coding.